Today, I will make the house of Bilbo Baggins. Draw the door and the windows and cut them with a spatula. Make the circular door. Use the mini spatula for the windows. Draw the lines around the windows and the door. With the mini spatula, draw the bricks. Blow the sand away. With the very wet sand, add the canopy. Use a mini spatula to finish it. Add the lantern. Make the last window in the same way. Don't forget the inside. Finish the decoration of the door and add the handle. Use the grass for the roof. The chimney. Add plants and make the stairs. And finally, the bench. And now we go inside. Hello, Bilbo. Where are you? Wow, one ring. Very interesting. Today, I will make the Tower of Mordor. With a mini spatula, make the two walls on top of the tower. Use the smallest tool to draw the decorations. With a spatula, sculpt the shape of the lower part. With a mini spatula, cut the little triangles all around the tower. Finish the lower part and... I am lost! I cannot find the exit! I hope the hide doesn't see me. The eye is watching me! I am not Frodo Baggins! I am not Frodo Baggins! I will hide in the cave of Mount Doom. I don't like this ring. I will put in the volcano. Oh, run for your life! The Bardur Tower is collapsing. Unbelievable. Thank you, Eagle. You saved my life. The Secrets of Lord of the Rings. About the house of Bilbo Baggins. How did I make the interior? This is a room of the Sand Sculptor shop, but the idea is the same. I made the interior on the table of my studio. But how did I open the door? I carved the door completely closed, and after I switched off the camera and I carved again one other door little bit open, and I switched on the camera. I repeated this operation like 5 times till the door was open enough. About the second episode, The Tower of Mordor. Of course, I downloaded an image from the internet. With a very good sand, it is possible to build this tower in exactly the same proportion. But in this case, I decided don't take any risk of collapse. And I made one tower a little bit short and fat, but in a good proportion. I hope. And now we are in the Kingdom of Mordor. It is a big pile of sand with all around many trees. It is perfect for the landscape of the last 2 episodes. The day before I started shooting with the camera, honestly I only use my phone, I made the Mount Doom and I compacted the sand for the Tower of Sauron. The mouth of the volcano is a little further down from the camera side, so that you can see the fire better. I also did a test to understand what the effect of smoke and fire would have been like, just to be sure. The effect was good. About the Tower of Sauron, I dug a hole to hide and manipulate Sauron's eye. I used a very strong light. It was important to focus the light on one point. The hard part was maneuvering the light from behind the tower without being seen. And without touching the tower, so not to damage it. The fun part, the Eye of Sauron. Cardboard, a pen, scissors, paints, a sheet of paper, glue and tape. I connected the light to a wooden stick and covered everything with a black cloth. With a tape, I connected the light with the height, and voila, the Siren High was ready. Today, I will make the Tower of Mordor. With a mini spatula, make the two holes on top of the tower. Use the smallest tool to draw the decoration. With the spatula, sculpt the shape of the lower part. With a mini spatula, cut the little triangles all around the tower. Finish the lower part and... I am lost! I cannot find the exit! I hope the high doesn't see me. The high is watching me! I am not Frodo Baggins! I am not Frodo Baggins! I will hide in the cave of Mount Doom. I don't like this ring. I will put in the volcano. Oh, run for your life! The Barad-dûr Tower is collapsing. Unbelievable. Thank you, Eagle. You saved my life.